travel via wormhole has long been a staple of science fiction across all forms of media. But these objects have always remained purely theoretical, meaning such travel methods, so far, have been restricted to flights of fancy. But this isn't the case. What if, like in Interstellar, you could zip through from one point in space to another? Well, what would be the implications? Is this instantaneous teleportation really viable? It just might be. The physics behind wormholes. To understand what we're getting into, we need some preliminary knowledge. Wormholes are geometries of space-time in which there is an imaginary tunnel, or tube, connected to another region. Theorists believe that time within the interior of a wormhole is not linear, meaning one might even travel backwards through time and signals can traverse great distances across vast regions almost instantaneously. Since the interior of a wormhole is not affected by the surrounding space-time curvature, light signals can be transmitted across an event horizon, even with universes outside of our own. You may be aware, in the center of a black hole is a gravitational singularity, a one-dimensional point which contains an infinite mass where density and gravity become infinite, and space-time curves infinitely. Where the laws of physics as we know them cease to operate, since the exact physics of a singularity are not known because it involves infinities, one of the solutions within general relativity is that the region actually becomes a spherical mouth connected to a tunnel in space-time itself. It can then appear as a route through space-time, in which case another mouth can appear at any distance or time away from the initial one. By folding a sheet of paper, it is possible to visualize how wormholes operate. The two ends of the sheet of paper may be 10 centimeters apart, but when the sheet is folded, as is shown in the image below, the points are less than a centimeter apart. Wormholes are great theoretical fun, but are seemingly valid solutions of the Einstein equations. There is, however, no experimental evidence for them. They are not really a means of going back in time. It is impossible. But if they exist at all, it may be a shortcut between two distant points in space. How plausible are wormholes? That depends on the scientists. Obviously, some scientists would completely accept wormholes, whereas others won't. They are hypothetical theories. However, if our knowledge of space-time is correct, then wormholes could be a possibility. Space-time is a continuum, and whether it's a theory or not, it tells us how gravity and dark energy work, as well as orbits, solar systems, black holes, etc. When there is a large mass, like a star, space-time bends downwards, causing other masses, smaller than that star, to be attracted to the star. This is gravity. Dark energy bends space-time upwards, so masses move away from it. Gravity and dark matter do not interact. If space-time were to bend 180 degrees, two different places in the universe and time would be close to each other, even though they are in the same distance away. If a hole were to be made through this gap, there could be a way to get somewhere completely different in space and time much quicker. Here's a diagram to help you. Instead of going around space-time, you could go through the hole, which would save you a lot of time. We don't know how these would exist and what kind of universal incident could ever create such a thing, but if we could manipulate space-time and be able to control it, we could potentially make a smaller version of one of these. We would bend a portion of space-time 180 degrees and would prick a hole through it. Negation of the theory. One can get wormhole solutions to Einstein general relativity equations, but there's a debate on whether they could describe even hypothetically possible things, or if they are mathematical artifacts that would disappear if we have a theory that combines gravity with quantum mechanics. Solutions for a wormhole require something called exotic matter, defined as the wormhole throat. It needs to have more energy than the mass energy density to create it. The only problem is, to do this, you need something with a negative mass energy, which has never been observed on a macroscopic scale. Trying to minimize the amount of exotic matter still requires matter with densities and energies difficult to exist in our own universe, like the center of the largest neutron stars. With all these conditions, wormholes, if they exist, are either extremely unstable, collapsing instantly, or require extremely wild exotic material that likely doesn't exist. If they could exist, they would require both exotic material, negative energy density, as well as some ultra-extreme materials, like cores of neutron star matter, to be constructed using quantum entanglement. A breakthrough occurred in late 2017 when physicists Daniel Jeffries and Aaron Wall, then at Princeton, discovered a way to prop open wormholes with quantum entanglement. Quantum entanglement is at the heart of quantum mechanics, but the idea it poses is simple. It's one of the uber-bizarre phenomena inside the quantum realm where two or more particles link up in a certain way. No matter how far apart they are in space, their states remain linked. That means they share a common, unified quantum state, so observations of one of the particles can automatically provide information about the other entangled particles, regardless of the distance between them. And any action to any one of these particles will invariably impact the others in the entangled system. The peculiar nature of entanglement allows it to provide the ingredient needed for wormhole stability. Entanglement is a standard feature of quantum physics and is relatively easy to create. Though the method helps to stabilize wormholes, it can still deliver only microscopic ones. But this new approach has inspired a stream of work that uses the entanglement trick with different sorts of matter in the hopes of bigger, longer-lasting holes. But this breakthrough is strong enough to turn science on its tracks and have a recounted statement about the feasibility of wormholes in the universe. According to Brianna Gardeau-White, a physicist and wormhole researcher at Brandeis University, we're learning that we can, in fact, build wormholes that stay open using simple quantum effects. For a very long time, we didn't think these things were possible to build. It turns out that we can. Are black holes also wormholes? Scientists first discovered black holes not through observations in the universe, but through the mathematics of Einstein's theory of general relativity. Those equations showed that if you crunch down enough matter into a small enough volume, then gravity overwhelms every other force and shrinks the matter down into an infinitely tiny point, known as the singularity. Black holes are one-way trips. Once someone crosses their boundaries, known as event horizons, they can't ever escape. While black holes were once considered just a trick of Einstein's equations, astronomical observations eventually revealed that black holes do exist in the universe, so maybe the same could be said of wormholes. So while the only thing at the center of a black hole is a singularity, the same mathematics also allows for the exact reverse of a black hole, a white hole. A white hole still has a singularity at its center and an event horizon surrounding it. But instead of falling in and finding it impossible to escape, with a white hole, a person could never reach the event horizon from the outside because it's constantly flinging its contents out into the universe faster than the speed of light. In theory, a black hole may be paired with a mirror twin, called a white hole, to form a wormhole. Still, these theoretical wormholes would look nothing like the ones depicted in science fiction. Traditional wormholes are predicted to be incredibly unstable, meaning they'd collapse the moment a single particle of matter entered them. So while wormholes are consistent with the physics of general relativity, but that's not the whole story. You'd also require exotic matter with negative mass, which may not exist, and about a million suns worth of normal matter. All this has to be arranged in the correct configuration to prevent it from collapsing on itself. The real import of this work is in its relation to the black hole information problem and the connections between gravity and quantum mechanics. So there you are, guys. I hope this video offers some good insight. If you enjoyed it, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more content just like this. And as always, thanks for watching.